Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Astroneers. And on tonight's episode, we are going to be continuing where we left off. Now, for those of you who may have missed the last episode, we got a lot done on that one. I got even more done in between this one and the last one. I took a little bit of time to come here and just kind of rearrange my base, kind of neaten it up a little bit, put some storage where storage needs to be made. You guys can see that I got a lot more power units. I put down a few more batteries, and I didn't build anything we didn't already have access to, so you guys didn't miss anything new. And if I did find any new technology things that we could research, I didn't actually research them yet, so we're gonna put that on the little thing and see what the little pinwheel gives us out of our little secret Santa surprise. I don't even know what to call that other than just like random research out of these items. But yeah, a base is coming along. It's looking pretty good. It's getting a little bit bigger now. Most of you guys know that when I record these episodes, I tend to record sometimes anywhere from like 10 to 20 episodes at one time before the first one ever gets posted. So you guys have left a ton of comments down below. A lot of things I didn't know. Some of the things I did. One of the things I didn't know about was this right here. This actually creates energy, and you can pick it up eventually once you get the arm and I believe a second attachment, because I do have the arm, but it wouldn't let me pick this up. I did come over here and give it a shot. I actually was going to give that a shot before I even knew it was something, but now that I know it's going to give me a lot of power, we're definitely going to be keeping our eye on that. Now, over here, I did happen to find another research module just sitting over here when I was trying to pick that thing up. So I went ahead and grabbed it, put it back over here next to the base. We're going to research that really quick and see what we get out of it. And then I'm going to show you something else that I probably should have figured out a long time ago, but for some weird reason, it just didn't occur to me or Cypher to give it a shot with the controls as they are. So let's go ahead and hit this. This should give us a new piece of technology. Anytime you see capsules like this that aren't like actual organic, you almost always get something like this. Give me something good. Fuel condenser. Now, I believe that's what Cypher was using to actually make the fuel for the rocket out of regular power. So let's come over here and see if we can do that. I believe it's storage, wind turbine, battery generator, one seat, solar panel. I don't see it in there. So let's come over here to one of our empty tables. Fuel condenser. It might be an actual table in its own right. And I do have a couple over here just kind of sitting here waiting to be used. One of these is going to be another vehicle base so that I can actually make more vehicles when my rocket is sitting over here in the shop. Let's see. Vehicle bay, printer, fuel condenser. There we go. And we need copper for that. So let's see if we have any copper, which I believe we have a small amount if we didn't use it all. I believe most of that is aluminum. There's some copper right there. So let's go ahead and grab the copper, put that on the back of our... in fact, we might actually already have one back there. I gotta empty my backpack before we go out. But here's the fuel condenser. Let's put these on. No, I think I have aluminum back there is what I had. One raw, yeah, and one actually refined. So let's close that down. There we go. And let's make this and see what we get. Now, we actually have some energy sitting right there on the pad, but you can see it's going to go ahead and charge up with the fuel that we already have, the energy sitting over there in storage, being made from a number of resources. We have the solar reactor, we have the wind turbine, and we have all the batteries to store it. Okay, so let's go ahead and fill that up, and you'll see right there it's going to fill it up with goo, the green... what is it called? The hydrazine or whatever it's called. That's what it's going to do. And that entire thing is going to get filled up and make one itty bitty thing out of that. No, that's not what I want. Actually, it may have made more than one itty bitty thing out of that. I think I just didn't have the storage. So let's try that again. But this time, let's take the power off of here. We're going to take this right there. We'll put the power back on if it will let us actually look at it the way we want to. We'll put the power back on. We'll put the hydrogen there, and now when we click it, if it immediately makes one, which it doesn't seem like it is, oh, there it goes. You can see it from the side. All right. Let's see how long does it take, because I think you make a little bit more than full. Nope, I think that's it. I think that's all it makes, and it doesn't auto take it off. Well, at least we can take those, which now we're using with unlimited resources, and sell them over here on the trade platform. Now, I think I filled this up with almost a full thing of this one, and I didn't get any lithium out of it. Doesn't necessarily mean you won't get something else, like two compounds. Compounds? Yeah, I think we could do that. Let's... Will it not trade? Okay, so I think we're going to go with two of those for a compound. Let's actually sell that. Oh, look at it go up in the sky. Oh my god, I don't think I've ever clicked that thing down. So we might have to wait a little bit for it to come back in. Huh. That is interesting to know. I like the little detail. It's not instant. It's not like magic. You actually have to work for it. Okay, so while that's going on and we got daylight out here, let's go ahead and do a couple more. That way if we do need those, I believe we need to... Yeah, let's run over here and take these things off. That way we are not full up on our inventory before we go down. Now, one of the big things that I know probably a lot of you guys will have been shouting for quite some time. I just now started getting comments letting me know this was even a thing. And I thought it was something that I had to actually grow access to. Oh, there it comes in. Nice. That is really, really nice. Yeah, I thought it was something I had to develop access to through research, but there is a flattening tool and there is a rising tool instead of just a digging tool. And I thought it was just digging. So yeah, definitely my apologies on that one, guys. I know I'm probably bringing some people to just go absolutely nuts screaming at the screen. One of the things that I would say though is I did get some comments letting me know that these little platforms, these little pieces of storage, nobody, or at least from what I read on there, a lot of people didn't even know you could put them down on the table. So where I may have missed one thing, it seems like maybe I found another. But yeah, I like the game, and we're getting lithium here, which is amazing. That's definitely what we need. Let's go ahead and get in our vehicle. Now, I did empty that out so that we had plenty of space, and we're going to be taking both of them down with us. This is my new leveled playing field over here, and I think we're gonna connect onto both of these here in a second if we can. There we go. Let's actually connect these so that we can take them down with us if it will let me. There we go. Now when you go into your building tool, you'll see this is the normal one. If you click on something, it will get rid of it. It'll start to eat it away. If you hit the left bumper, you'll see the little arrows on them change. Now, this is the leveling tool, almost like a copy and paste tool, think of that way. If you click on a piece of ground that is level, now anything that you put this over with will become as level as that piece of ground. So it's nice. You can flatten things with it. The other cool thing about it is if you find a piece of ground that, say, maybe is at an angle and you click on it that way, now it will make all of those a piece at an angle. So you can create a very, very quick ramp within seconds, and it is really, really smooth. And it's going to be as steep as you want it to be as steep. If you click on a really steep piece of ground when you first get that copy in there, it's going to be really steep from then on. If you get something that's nice and... you know, smooth, almost to the point of being flat, but just at a slight grade, then from then on, you're going to be making that too. So your ramps will be really long, but actually pretty nice to get up. The other thing I would let you guys know about that I didn't know was going to be a thing are these rocks that always get in the way. One of the reasons for me creating this flat piece of land was to get rid of these things. And as soon as I was done, a dust storm came in, and all these rocks and these plants came back. So if you're thinking about creating land just to get rid of those things, think again, guys. I guess the game programmers did not want you to be able to have that ability. Now, I came up this way, and then it started to come down at an angle. That way, I could go into the next little area. And I went ahead and put down tethers, kind of leading me into the areas that I have designated as my main places. So, kind of cool. We're building like this rail system almost, where we know where we're going, almost a little scuba diving area with interplanetary in mind. But this right here, I've added these. They not only transfer power and oxygen, but they, you know, give off a decent amount of light as well. Now remember, the more weight you're carrying behind you, this one actually I had built manually myself and then came back and fixed. You'll see that it does lean slightly to the left. That's before I really realized that the very first thing that you copy is what it's going to make all the other ones out of. This one, I really kind of figured that out, and you can see it's a lot more even, a lot more smooth on both sides. It doesn't lean too much to the left or the right for the most part. Still a little bit to the left. It kind of still always wants to go that direction. And now we're like three levels down inside this massive world. And I haven't really explored a lot down here. I did put up a few little markers for places that I thought would be kind of cool to explore later down the road, but there's so many things down here to mine that I was just like, oh, this is going to take a long time. But I did find this, and I went ahead and left it there so you guys would be able to see where it was at. I don't know if these will always be in the same places on everybody's map. I doubt it. I think every map is pretty much a unique experience, kind of almost to the point where it's randomly generated when you first start the game. But those, again, I think are going to give us research. And there's another one in here, too. And I kind of hate to be like, oh, I explored already, because I really did. This tunnel over here, I put down these little markers just to say, oh, you know, that would be a cool little place to explore. And then, I don't know, something about it just kind of shot me over here in this direction. And I kept going around the wall, and I'm like, okay, I'll just mark out all these. I got plenty of tethers. Didn't really happen. This place is huge. Now, one thing we haven't really done yet is set off a stick of dynamite, and there's a lot of them throughout this place, so we're gonna try that really quick. We're gonna click it, and we're gonna run for our lives there and see just how big of an explosion that made. You know, not really as big as I thought it would be. It does make a crater size, though, and it, for some reason, leaves the stuff that's floating on top just kind of there, so I'm thinking they're probably gonna fix that. I doubt that's the way they're gonna leave it. It's a little weird. It is an alien planet. Maybe gravity works differently here, but pretty sure it doesn't work that differently. Now, for all I know, right over the hill over there, there could be more secrets, more research that I'm not aware of, but this is the tunnel I chose to come into just straight off the bat, just to kind of look around. And I chose to go right, which I think might have been a mistake. I mean, not really a big mistake or anything like that, but there is a piece of technology over here I definitely want to pick up. But also, when I went left, I think I'm going to have to get out of here because there's so much of this stuff. And I do watch out because some of these plants, they stab you when you go by, even if you're not trying to take them down. And some plants only react when you're trying to take them down. But some of these, they just don't want you walking by them, period. So let's put this back over here. So now we got two of those. And I'll show you the rest of what I found over here. Now this was a straight fall off. So I went ahead and built a ramp. It's pretty steep, but it does get me down to the next level. And the next level is massive. This is just huge, guys. This takes me over into this cave system, which goes and goes and goes and goes. There was a small backpack over here, and I did go ahead and grab some of the stuff off of it. This backpack had, I believe, a battery and an oxygen kit, and then it had some dynamite on it and a few resources. So I left what I didn't have space for. Of course, at the time, I was doing a lot of exploring of my tethers. So I went ahead and took the oxygen kit and the battery. So I have three of each of those now. Ooh, and there's a unknown. I didn't even see that here. So let's go ahead and snag that. Pick that up. Now, I know a lot of you guys were saying that your OCD was going off because I was leaving all these holes. Well, like I said, I just didn't know how to fix them. And now that I know how to fix them, I definitely am covering them over as I get done with them, because it's just so much nicer to have that ability where I don't get stuck in these potholes anymore. I really, really, really wish I had known about this. I think we might be going the wrong way. Let me throw this down for a second and see if I can find the way I came back. We're gonna run out of oxygen if I don't figure this out. Was it down this way? Oh, geez. This is why I was putting the tethers down. Yeah, it was this way. Okay, let me get back to the tethers. There we go. Fill me back up, guys. Both in energy and oxygen. It does take a little bit of time, but that's because we have so much time away from these things before I actually start losing any oxygen because I'm carrying so much. I can imagine the day when I have just tons and tons of these things in my backpack so I can explore. Okay, so now that I know where I am, where did I leave that container? Right over here? Yeah, this is why I want to explore down here. I was going to make the episode about going to another planet, but, you know, there's so much already here, and we just discovered a brand new area, and now we got research that we can do to things that could make a huge difference. Now, on my spaceship, I did figure out that you can go ahead and throw one of the storage units that you would normally throw down on one of your platforms that will unfold. You can throw that down on the back of your spaceship too if you go with a one-seater. Because that's the case, I don't know if the resources will come off when I take off into the sky. For all I know, all of them will just pop right off and you'll lose everything you put on there. But it will give me a chance to, at the very least, throw a few of the resources I know I'll need when I get there, such as resin, maybe a few compounds, some of the simple stuff so that I can get a building going. And you have 8 to choose from. There's a lot that you can put on there with an 8. Now, I did come over here to the left just a tad bit, just to kind of stick my head around the corner. I didn't really get too far in it. You can see the caverns go off a long way in that direction, a long way in that direction. But one of the things I did notice is they go down. So we can go even further down than we already are. And we're pretty far down, guys. So this right here, this little ramp that I built, this is the furthest that I came down. It does split off into 3 different sections down here. You can see it goes to the right, which used to be the tunnel, and it goes over to the left, and it also goes straight down. And that's, oh no, 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 no. I don't know what's going on, but you guys need to stop it. Holy crap, no. I'm gonna lose my vehicle. Stop, guys, stop, stop it. Oh, and we got a new piece of technology. Well, if that isn't completely and totally worth it, I don't know what is, but let's go ahead and stick that sucker right there on the back. Ah, no, you're not gonna do it, huh? You don't wanna do it while there's nothing for you to be able to move. All right, well, let's see, can we flip these things over? Oh man, I don't know if we can. I need room to back up and turn, and it doesn't quite seem. Yeah. Oh my God. Stop it. It's going back up the ramp for me. It's, no, 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 it's not. Come on, let me back in, let me back in, let me back in. You're facing the right way now, at least. Here we go. So maybe 4, yeah, maybe 2 trucks and 2 rovers is a bit much for down here. Come on, get me up, get me up, get me up. Oh, flip over already, guys. I wish there was a manual way to do it, because if I get out right now and turn my flashlight on, it doesn't let me flip this over. Ah, there we go. That one actually worked. Huh, I wonder if it's because there's an arm on there, because it would never let me do that before in the past. Here we go. Come on, come on, come on, come on. You can do it. What are you stuck on? It must be these things. These little pyrite, or whatever you want to call them, the stalactites that are getting in the way. And hate to dig into this tunnel because it was nice and smooth too. How about over here? You guys stuck on those too? Yeah, it looks like they are. All right, let me see if I can fix this real quick, guys. Just kind of, may not be perfect, but it will put it back to a point that we might not have any potholes. There we go. Actually, that seemed pretty perfect right there. And now we're out of energy, so that's perfect timing. Come on, move! Move! Oh, here we go, here we go! Yo, nice. Jeez. These tunnels, man, they get me every single time I come back in. No! What are you doing? You have energy. What are you getting stuck on? Oh, I hate you guys. I hate you guys so much. Alright, you want me to build you a ramp? I'll build you a ramp. Let's put that on. We'll go ahead and make the ramp a little longer. Kind of get that in there. Doesn't seem like it's gonna take. At least not yet. There we go. Is it all on there? Yes. Yes, they are. Don't give me any more trouble, dudes. Come on, go, 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 go. Oh, come on. Rovers, this is why I take you guys off. Because you just ain't worth it. How about that? Now you're not stuck. Yeah, I really think the rovers are more of a hindrance than they are anything else. They just don't have the pickup that these trucks do. And, you know, I realize they're not supposed to, but the amount that they have gets in the way more than anything. Way more in the way than it should. You know what? We could pick some of those up. I guess we will. Let's go back into the main cave system that's closest to the main ramp. That can even be a thing, because we're pretty far away from everything. And we're going to grab some of these guys. Just one of these regular ones, something like this dude right here that happens to be stuck in there. There we go. We'll stick that on the back. This thing is not creating any more power, even though we are inside. Let me see if I can take this solar panel off back here and put it right back here. That's where I used to have it. Actually, I think I used to have it right here on top of my main one. Let's see, we need to get rid of some of these guys too. These are the ones you gotta dig a little bit deeper into to get rid of, and they usually have some sort of resource at the bottom of them, but I am not seeing any resources over here underneath them. That is kind of weird, but now I can cover them up. Come on, there we go. Keep going, keep going. Power is, like I said, one of the things you run out of a lot down here if you're going to be covering up or digging down. The cool thing about that is your vehicle will transfer power to you, as will those tethers. So you really, if you're just kind of cautious about where you put those down, you're never too far away from being able to resupply on your power and your oxygen. Okay, yeah, you wanna smack me in my face a little bit and then go down even deeper. There we go. Come on, get it over there. Right there. Let's get inside. I think we have enough for maybe 3 or 4 more of those. We could also go with a few resources. I should have covered that up too. Let's kind of just patrol, guys. Let's take a look around. Oh yeah, that's a good one. Let's go ahead and snag this. It's just sitting right there, guys. There we go. How many more do we got? 1, 2... Maybe just 2 more? 2 more, and we still got a decent amount of power left. Leave those guys there for now. Hopefully I don't fall down a hole over here or something. Resources... Got another one right there I could dig up. Maybe we'll get that one on the way back. Another one right there. Just kind of going for looksy, guys. What? Where did those come from? We just had resin fall from the sky? Also had compound fall from the sky. There's nothing up there. That is pretty weird. That kind of sounds like maybe a little bug. Maybe I am right underneath one of my other tunnels and somehow it glitched down before the floor. So I don't know. I don't know how that would work. I've never seen that before. Come on, let me snag it. Yeah, there we go. This is what I want. Let's put that on there. Yep. We'll leave the resin. Ooh, yes, please. Grab it. There's 2 in there. Okay, we gotta pop these. There we go. Will you let me grab it? 1 right there. And do we have room for you anywhere? Nope. We'll put it right on the front. We do have room for it up there. Right there, nice. Now, you could put your drill up there too. That's something I've done in the past. Oh my god, this place is huge. Let's see if we can back ourselves out a little bit. We'll turn around right here. Stalactites going crazy. We got resources going crazy. Come on, come on. Now, when I did have the drill, and that was the game where me and Cypher were playing it together. When I did have the drill and I put it on the front, it wouldn't actually bust through stalactites. It would dig through the ground, but it wouldn't get rid of those rocks. I don't know if there's any good way to do that. I don't know if maybe dynamite will blow those up. It doesn't seem like it does. Just kind of blows the ground only slightly, too. I really don't know why you would use dynamite. If it was a massive explosion, I would definitely be telling you guys dynamite is worth it. But as it stands right now, not so much, in my opinion. Here we go. Now, most of the tethers are on the ceiling, but I did put a few on the ground because the ones up there on the top were a little bit too high to actually be feeding me resources such as oxygen and energy. And, you know, when you're digging down here, you need both of those. So, yeah, I did kind of put a little bit down in the ramp. Sometimes I even covered them up with dirt so that they're completely covered, and yet they still give off Oh, no. What is going on? What, are we too heavy? Oh, we're out of energy. Oh, okay, well, what we can do... Let's see, can we just throw energy onto the back? Yeah, sure can. So we'll throw energy on there. It's gonna power it up. I don't think this is gonna be enough, but we'll keep giving it a shot. We only need to get up a little bit higher, and then it should power us up. These, like I said, were a little bit too high up off the ground. We even use these to kind of give ourselves a little bit more power. Yeah, two vehicles wide. Should be good. Let's do this one. Nope, doesn't seem to want to put that one on there. There we go. Ah, come on. It was powering up my battery from the vehicle. So all that energy that I just put onto it was just being taken off. And for all I know, it's not equal, so I'll probably be losing energy in that that transaction. Come on, go. There we go. I can see the power being transferred over to the vehicle now. We should be good. Keep going. Get in there. Yeah. Wow, this is going to be a nice little chunk of technology. At least three that I'm seeing. And that's if those two blocks are what I think they are. No guarantee that I'm going to get technology out of that, but I'm pretty sure that they are, because they're not something I've run into before. Which to me denotes rare, and rare denotes technology, or at least that's what I would assume. Now, some people have mentioned that when you pick those things up, you can't... Oh, there's a dust storm coming in? Or just leaving? Could just be clouds. Yeah, you have a chance at getting a certain technology, and if you already have it, you'll just get resources out of that. So that could be why when I brought back all those little nodes that I got from down below, we didn't actually get... Oh, yeah, there's the sandstorm. Yeah, we didn't actually get any technology out of that. Come on, get up there. Such a pig with these rovers. These things move so much faster without them. No! This is so realistic. Can't see anything. Got rocks flying through the air. Can you imagine how terrifying this would be in an actual rover? You're just like, please. I hope the guys back at home base knew what they were doing. And I don't have any energy out here anymore. So I am stuck. Oh, and we're taking hits. Yeah, we're gonna have to wait it out. Because I am stuck right now with all these things on them. So close to power. Any one of these bricks. Like, my cab's not even protected. I get that I'm in, like, a vehicle, but... My cab is not even protected. I imagine I take one of those rocks in the face, I'm still dead. So maybe they will integrate that into the game at some point as well. But until they do, we're left dealing with this. I thought that transferred power. I could have swore it did. Maybe my base is out of power at the moment. Let me go over there and take a look. How much power do I have on me? Yeah, it has plenty of power. Not sure why it wouldn't transfer energy to this thing. But we are gonna have to take one of these things off so we can put power on it. Let's see, we'll do instant power, if it will let me put it on there. Ah, it won't let me put it on the front, only the back. All right, let's close this thing down so we can actually move at a decent pace. And we're gonna have to come down here to the bottom because that's where this thing fell off, apparently. Oh man, how are we gonna do this? What if I take that off? I could use some coal to give it some power. Is it charging? No, it's not gonna charge because it's made to store and not to use. All right, well, somebody said that coal isn't used for anything other than energy, and I do got a lot of it, so let me go ahead and just snag one, hoping that they are right on that one, that it's not actually used on anything else. And we'll just give ourselves a little bit of energy until the sun comes up and this thing can start creating energy of its own. I should put a windmill on here if it's gonna be that big of a problem, but I've never gone that deep before that it ever has. Okay, coal right there. Yep, it's creating energy now. Let's go. Let's book it back to base and hope that it can get up, because I'm not 100% guaranteeing that it can. Go, 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 go. Looks like it's moving. Looks like it's moving. Come on, come on, come on. Yeah. Yeah, that's some power on those trucks. Let's get this thing close to one of these. Keep it coming, keep it coming. A little bit more. One more. Yeah, right there, that seems good. Let me connect the back on there. Actually, you know, it's creating a lot of power off of that coal. That is actually crazy power. We'll connect it anyways, just so we can put some power into it, but wow, I was not expecting coal to generate that much fuel. Alright, let's go ahead and do one of these very first ones that I can remember being the square shaped. And yes, we are gonna get new technology. Give me something good. A winch. Okay, I think the winch is what we needed to take that other block, the solar reactor that somebody told me about. That's a little bit further away from our base. You can see it right there in the distance, straight ahead. You need that little winch. So we're gonna give that a shot. As soon as we can build it, we're gonna find out what we need. But let's go do these other two before we end the episode here, guys, and then give those things a shot on the next episode. Yes, 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 yes. Something good, something good. Everything's good at this point, but drill head, okay, yeah, we got the arm, now we got the drill head, we can use both of those. Come on, get this in there, gimme, gimme, gimme. Oh, what do you guys think we're gonna get on this one? We gotta take bets on some of these and figure out if you guys know these things as well as some of you guys say you do. A spaceship? What do you mean a spaceship? I already have a spaceship. Does it have rooms on it? Like, oh my god, I can only wait. So many things to build the next one, guys. Come on, really? So I already had that one, is what it's telling me. I already had that piece of technology. Alright, well that was a little disappointing. I was expecting something new. Let's grab these guys. Maybe I'm getting a little spoiled on all the technology we're getting. Gotta go after some resources every once in a while. There we go, let's put that one on there. And now it's working, now the sun is out, so that solar reactor over there is doing good. Oh, we got some lithium. Again, lithium lets me build those batteries, and I do love having a lot of battery banks on here, so those times when I need that energy, I don't have to worry about it, especially when I was building those tunnels. You'd be surprised, guys, that I would use so much energy building those tunnels and digging the ramps and all that kind of stuff, that all the energy up here that was feeding me would actually wear away before it became just daylight again. And that's with three batteries on there, so you know, it kind of makes me want to build at least two more in case I ever have to do that again, because it can be very extensive. I mean, I did that for a good 3 hours, I think, one day. Oh yeah, I got some more coal, so it paid me back what I used. Let's put that over here. Actually, let me pick that back up, because it didn't go on the table like it was supposed to. There we go. Put that right there. But guys, I think we're going to go ahead and end the episode here. I definitely want to thank you all for watching. Remember, guys, as you watch these episodes, just, you know, leave those comments down below, and I will definitely take your tips and suggestions into consideration as I go through the game. And you can kind of see this one was a little bit higher. It's actually building somewhat of a ramp instead of a flat platform. But that's all right. It's going to close it up enough, and I can come back in at a later date and level it out a little bit more if I need to. But yeah, I try to do the ground just slightly next to it so that it at least blends in a little bit. And you can see right there all that energy feeding in to my tether right behind you, that little yellow line. And normally this would take a lot of power. Here we go. Fill these in. Actually, I'm not filling them out. I'm just covering them up. I'm creating a very big problem for kids who will play here in the future. And they might cave into these things like they do in real life. That would be a nightmare scenario, but we are on an alien planet. And I'm guessing that if kids are going to be playing here, they're gonna be, I don't know, like futuristic kids that know how to deal with cave-ins and battery packs and sort of craziness. Now, I did put a plant down there, because you can't really pick up the plants. You can't chop them down, you can't destroy them. So if there's a tree in your way, or you just happen to take it down for whatever reason and it's on the ground now, it's pretty long, and it just stays there. It doesn't really do anything past that point, but it does get in the way of the vehicle. So I went ahead and dug a hole so I could put it down there and eventually cover it up so I didn't have to run into it anymore. Again, the rocks are something that just comes back naturally, so you won't ever truly be able to get rid of the rocks, but you can get rid of the trees. They may come back too eventually, but I don't really know how that works just yet. As always, guys, I want to thank you. I'm AC Gamer, and I will definitely catch you all next time. Hey guys, and welcome to the disembodied voice of AC Gamer. We are definitely going to be doing a lot more series in the future, but here are a few of them that you guys might find interesting. Of course, you're more than welcome to check them out. I would love to hear your comments. Again, if you do enjoy these videos, be sure to hit that like button, subscribe. It's definitely the indicator that I use to tell if you guys want to see more videos like that, of that particular game style, of that series in the long run. So when you guys leave comments down, it helps me decide whether we should keep doing it, as well as whether you want to see games like that in the future. And here are a few of them right here. I kind of picked out a few of different genres. We will be doing spotlights for other YouTubers in the future. So if you want to get a little shout out, definitely let me know. If you group with me, chances are you will get a shout out in here eventually, but for now, these are just four series that I have that I feel like could use a little bit more attention, and that you guys might actually enjoy as well. Thanks again for watching, guys, and we will definitely catch you all next time.